guys who joined us for our afternoon performance. Today, boys and girls, this is kind of our final dress rehearsal before 4th and 5th grade have their big concert tonight. So you get to be our test audience. We get to see how much you like our concert. These friends up here have been working very, very hard since the very beginning of the school year on the music that you're going to hear. So please give them the best attention and applaud so nicely after their hard work is done.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Mrs. Hoffman and the Franklin Elementary Chorus, we would like to welcome you to our winter concert, Let's Make It Shine.
We hope you enjoy our show, which we've been working on since September. We kindly ask that you take a moment to silence your cell phone.
We also ask that you refrain from taking flash photography during the concert, as it can be very distracting. We will be happy to post for photos after the concert is finished.
If you need to exit the gym during the concert, please wait for a pause between songs if possible. We would hate for you to miss any great music.
Throughout the performance, you will hear some narrations introducing each piece of music, including some poetry by poet Anna Brown Temple Hines, inspired by the lights and sounds of the season.
We thank you for coming and invite you to sit back, relax, and join in our festive mood. And now, let's make it shine.
During the dark months of the year, we turn to light, a dancing candle, a cozy fire, for comfort and to lift our spirits. Even natural lights have a special quality in winter. The morning sun glinting on the icicles, early sunsets, stars glittering in the cold, and moonlight on fresh snowfall. For some, the most cheerful of all may be the lights we use in winter celebrations. It is during December, the darkest months of the year, that our holiday lights inside and out shine the brightest.
Holiday magic. My street is dull and plain by day, but magic comes at night. Beaming from lampposts, streaming through windows, blinking on porches, twinkling on rooftops. Glinting from stars, gleaming from candles, glittering on evergreens, snowmen, and Santas. Luminous, lustrous, glimmering, blazing, enchanting, amazing light.
Let's get some balls. This place could use some. years ago, people didn't understand how the rotation of the Earth and its orbit around the Sun caused the winter months to grow darker and colder. They feared the Sun would disappear altogether. In many cultures, people celebrated winter solstice rituals in December to encourage the return of the Sun and its life-giving light.
Such rituals usually involve feasting, merrymaking, gift-giving, and decorating with evergreens as symbols of sustained life. They centered around fire and light of some sort, and including yule logs, bonfires, lighted trees, candles, and fireworks.
Solstice. December has the longest nights of any in the year. In centuries past, folks were afraid the sun would disappear. They lit grand fires to bring it back with feasting and good cheer.
Breathtaking natural light, warm, cozy indoor light, high-spirited holiday lights are all the more striking because of the cold and darkness that surround them. The bleakness of winter contrasts with the breathtaking colors and lights the winter sky and silver snow provide. Shades of blue, white, and silver flash by as we frolic in the frosty air.
August. And bright as a light bulb round as pie, the moon glows full in the winter sky. It's high overhead but far below, the moon paints pictures in the blue-white snow.
Thank you.
begin with the Feast of St. Lucia. St. Lucia was an Italian who was known to bring food and supplies to persecuted Christians hiding underground in the 3rd century.
Throughout Sweden, the eldest daughter in each family comes to her parents wearing a crown with 7 lighted candles. She brings them hot coffee and saffron buns, while the other children in the family hold candles and sing the light and joy of Christmas.
Today I wait while it's still night, for I'm Lucia. I wear a red sash and a gown of white. Shh, I'm Lucia. I bring coffee and saffron buns, for I'm Lucia. With a crown of candles on my head, I am Lucia, queen of lights.
Which focuses on light, hope, and dedication. The miracle of Hanukkah occurred 2,000 years ago when there was only enough oil for the lamp in the temple to burn for one night, but instead it lasted for 8. Today, the 8 days and nights of Hanukkah are marked with the lighting of the candles on the menorah.
Hanukkah lights another each night until there are 8. Flames romp on their heads, and I don't go to bed until they burn down to the toes.
Hanero, used to celebrate the winter solstice still play a prominent role in many celebrations of Christmas. Christmas trees topped with stars and brightly lit with candles or lights become a centerpiece of homes in December. Christians believe the star placed at the top of the tree represents the star of Bethlehem, which led Magi from the east to the place of the birth of Jesus Christ. For many, the lighting of the Christmas tree is a tradition to look forward to all year. It's time. We've been working, we've been waiting, we've been anticipating. Make it dark as it can be. It's time to light our Christmas tree.
Tree. Tip top wing, red blue bloom, yellow twinkle green, light white sparkling down to the bottom of a glorious tree.
Thank you.
shine inside you that never ends. And now we must bid you farewell and adieu. Happy holidays to all and happy new year too.
Audience.